Hello and welcome to the Sisters for Fitness Wellness Show. I'm Stephanie Gaines Bryant. Our guest today is Rob Howes, and he is the founder of Camp Fit. Welcome back. Not welcome, but welcome back.
Welcome back. Sound like a TV show.
Rob, what I love about what you're doing with Camp Fit is there are not a lot of folks out here who are doing what you're doing.
Yeah, I noticed that. I noticed that. That's why I started doing it. One of the reasons why I started doing it, I just knew it was a need, a gap that needed to be filled.
Camp Fit is a fitness camp for children. Mm-hmm. So tell us about it.
So think about when what children love to do. Have fun, move, talk. So Camp Fit is a program where kids can come, have fun, do those things, but they can also learn some of the soft skills as they're going to help them have prosperous lives in the future, like what to eat, how to eat it, how to think, how to set goals, how to understand who you want to be in life, getting to know the person on the inside at an early age. Like, we think that introspect type of things only happen when we become adults, but children need those outlets as well. So Camp Fit is that place where kids can develop themselves and just grow and get all the nurturing they need.
How long is the camp? How does it work?
So for the summer, it's 8 weeks long. And each week is segmented with different activities. So we start at 8 o'clock in the morning and about 3 o'clock. Throughout the day, there will be maybe a chef come to do some healthy cooking. Maybe we'll go on a field trip. Then we'll have some exercise. Then a presenter will come in teaching on a certain subject. Maybe it's, you know, goal setting. Maybe it's security. Maybe it's just entrepreneurship, whatever it may be. Again, different, expose them to different opportunities. That's the whole week. 8 weeks, we got the summer.
So who's coming through your doors? What children are you seeing, or what are you seeing when you work with these children?
Honestly, it's really a variety, middle school and high school. But typically—
Challenging times.
Oh, it's super challenging. Especially, you know, middle school is challenging. But high school is more challenging because you really think you know who you are when you really don't. So it's really difficult. It's easier when we catch them at middle school while they're starting to formulate their ideas. High school is a little more difficult, but it's still doable with consistency. You got middle school and high school kids.
One of the things I love is that you get kids to pay attention to those things,
yeah,
such as nutrition and things like that. When you have a child who's coming in with those issues, maybe they don't even know what a healthy meal looks like.
Yeah.
How do you introduce them to that?
You know, that's a good question. So we have, every day, we have our smoothies. Coach Roz, our health coach, and anyone else who comes, we'll do smoothies and certain meals. We'll introduce them. As a group, we're tasting it. And if that's what you're eating, that's all you have, then you're more open and receptive to it. And the food is good. It smells good. So now they get introduced to something they never knew about. They realize it's healthy, it is good, and it's going to benefit them. So that collectively just kind of incentivizes them to try it again, especially when we give them the ingredients to take home, cook with their family.
Exactly, because that's the whole experience there, is the fact that if they're getting it in camp, and they're not getting it at home, mm-hmm, how do they bring this home and say, hey, Mom, can we do some of this too?
Yep.
And there's some people are fast food families,
yeah,
where Mom's working hard or what, she doesn't have time to go to the store to buy fresh vegetables every other day, or she's got to do what she can,
yeah,
to meet the needs of the children,
yeah,
at that time. And sometimes that doesn't include the healthiest diet in the world.
You know what? That's so true. And unfortunately, that's the misconception that a lot of us have. Like, I even had it for a long time that if I don't have that much time, I just got to grab whatever's available. I did that for a long time until I realized it's not about the time I don't have. It's about how am I planning my time. So the preparation, like Abraham Lincoln said, give me 6 hours to cut down a tree. I'll spend the first four sharpening my axe. So he's spending three times as much time in preparation before execution. It's the same thing with everything. So if you prepare your meals for the week, prepare everything for the week, you won't be going back and forth to the grocery store. You'll have all your meals set. And yeah, you'll still have to spend a little time in the preparation and cooking. We think about the difference between you cooking and that fast food and how it's going to impact your life over time.
How do you, speaking of preparation, how do you prepare them for the future, yet make it fun?
Yeah.
How do you teach them goal setting?
So the first thing we do is we ask them to think about what makes them happy. What do you want to, like, what makes you happy? Start to paint that picture, right? What is that? Maybe it's singing, maybe it's writing, maybe it's starting your own business for dogs. Think about that. Like, what is that thing? And then we start to architect, how do we get that? How do we obtain that? Just the art of going through that exercise, it does something for the brain, releases these feel-good chemicals that allows you to want to repeat that same activity. Repetition is the mother of mastery, so over time, they accumulate.
So you get them thinking about what it is they want. Do you get them to write it down, or mm-hmm. how do you execute it from there?
So they have their goal books.
Okay.
Right? They write their goals down every day, and they review their goals. We talk about the challenges. Are you able to execute? What are some of the loopholes? What have you noticed? Talking it through. Sometimes you hit them, sometimes you don't. But just the process of doing that gets them closer than they would have ever been not having the conversation, right? And so it prepares them. Not everyone hits their goals, but they get into the habit of setting them, strategizing to execute. Setting them, strategizing to execute. And again, repetition. Eventually, they do that on their own, subconsciously. That's how we build those great habits.
How do you get them involved physically? Because we know that the whole nutrition piece is a part of it. How about physical activities? What do you guys offer at Camp Fit?
So every sport that you could think of, we play. We even do things that you don't even know you're exercising. You know, like little games outside, where it's movement. I mean, we have Zumba. So it's like, it's really just a variety of whole bunch of activities where we're moving. And we do have some specific things. We go to the CrossFit gym, or we'll go to the boxing gym. We'll get really intense. We have some intense, but a lot of it is just like going to the horseback, going to the horse farm. But that's really a donation, volunteer opportunity for them. But we do some activities on the farm. Like, yeah, so.
And that's exposing them. Some people have never seen a farm before.
Yeah, yeah, you'd be amazed. And they look at those horses like it's a dinosaur. Like, I was like, wow, it got me scared. Like, what, am I missing something? Because they were really fearful. But then, again, we have these exercises that teach them how to deal with their fear. There's one boy, I'm going to sing in the clip. He was petrified. I felt so bad for him. Donnie. And it was just like, he was stuck. And I said, look, just look at where you want to go. Just start walking that way. Horse will follow you. And he started walking that way. Horse followed him. He loosened up. Horse loosened up. He had a breakthrough. I loosened up. Everybody loosened up. Like, but you know, it's the process of looking at, again, look at where you want to go. You don't stay stuck in the fear because there's nothing there, but that feeling. Look at where you want to go and start moving. The moment he did that, triggered. So that's a parable. You know, everything we're teaching is similar. There's so many similarities.
A lot of kids nowadays, we hear a lot about the whole bullying thing. Mm-hmm. We hear a lot about kids with low self-esteem. Do you have a lot of kids who walk into your program with low self-esteem, and how do you deal with it?
Yeah, a lot. Because even we have that, you know?
Yes, as adults.
You know? Right. The best way to deal with low self-esteem is to look in the mirror and tell yourself, I love you. I think that's so weird. Yeah. Try it. Something happens. You look in the mirror and say, I love you. Think about all the good things about you. Just think about all the good things. See, what happens with low self-esteem is something has gotten your attention. You're focused on what somebody said or what didn't work out, and it just begins to dwindle. The way you shift that is to put your attention on something else, because you can't be on two things at one time. The moment you put your attention on what you love about yourself, all the greatness about you, telling yourself these affirmations, again, this repetition over time begins to reprogram.
Indeed it does. Mm-hmm. Indeed it does. What are some of the successes that you've seen with Camp Fit? How have you seen it benefit the kids? You guys have been in business for how long?
Oh, man. Wow. So our nonprofit was launched in 2008.
Okay.
Can't fit officially 2010, although we were already doing programmatic things, you know, but we made it official. We launched the Can't Fit program in 2010, so eight years.
So you've seen some successes. You've seen the fruits of your work.
I am reminded, it's a good thing, that I am reminded that I have aged. I'm reminded of that. But I've got kids who came in like this, and then now I'm going through their college graduation.
Wow.
Yeah. So we have one in particular young man by the name of Josh Baptist came into the program, really low self-esteem, couldn't even look at you in your eyes when he would talk, and just over time, he changed. He became coming to himself. He then decided he wanted to go out for football. He then got a scholarship to a college. I mean, then he comes back to the camp and serves as a mentor for the kids who are going the exact same thing that he went through.
Isn't that what it's about?
Yeah, that's it. That is exactly what it's about. That is the model for humanity.
Is giving back
mm-hmm.
what he's given.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
How many kids do you deal with each year? How many are in your group?
In between 20 and 30. We were looking at the 50 model this year, you know, because we're going to add a couple of different components to it. Because we have some kids that were in the program that are coming back, we said, okay, let's figure out what we can do division-wise. So Camp Fit is not just for kids to come and lose weight. It's for them to come and just find themselves, grow, and get in the best shape mentally, physically, and spiritually. Those three components, those three main roads, everything in life comes down those three roads, mind, body, and spirit.
And so you're going to expand. So how are you planning to do that? Or how do you recruit your children?
So a lot of it's retention, a lot of it's referral based off, you know, past campers. We do the Facebook and typical social media, and that's pretty much it. And then, you know, a lot of the schools, the principals and vice principals and administrators, a lot of times refer kids they think will be a good fit for the program. I mean, really, anyone's a good fit, but sometimes it's like, you know, we got to get this one on the right path quickly.
So you get kids that you've had, for example, for a couple of years. So you get a couple of years mm-hmm. to expose them, to mm-hmm. work with them.
Yep. And then after the year's up, after the summer is up, we have our trainers who then do follow-ups. You
know? And what do they do?
So, like, for example, Coach Roz, she has her nutrition and her Zumba. And so the girls can stay in contact, take some Zumba classes. Coach Roz is still there to answer any questions, support them and the family in that same area of health and wellness. You know, so that's essentially how it works, just to keep everything flowing.
Yeah, because you can't just do this wonderful thing and then just disappear.
Yeah.
So there's got to be some follow through. Rob, what made you come up with this whole idea of Camp Fit? What in your background kind of made you decide this is what you wanted to do?
Well, I've always loved sports and fitness and wellness, God and psychology, mindset. I've always loved all of that. And I understand the importance of all of those. And I do understand that if I had access to a little more information when I was younger, I would have made some totally probably different choices. I'm glad I did. I'm glad I'm me, because I couldn't be me without everything that happened. But I do know that you can shorten the learning curve for kids. They don't have to repeat the same mistakes. And if we deliver the information, the content, and the opportunities the right way, we can literally change the world. I mean, I'm talking about hypertension, diabetes, heart attacks, the divorce rate, addictions, opiate deaths. I mean, you're talking about everything that plagues us, we can reverse. There will always be a percentage of it, because there's a polar opposite to everything. But we can diminish the percentage in those negative categories just by having this kind of collective effort. So that's why, long story, that's why I started, because I knew that we can make a huge change in the future. What we do today, thousands of years from now, will matter.
Indeed. I totally agree. Mm-hmm. You talked about things like, and that's why I hit the nutrition piece first. You talked about some of these chronic illnesses that especially affect African Americans, the diabetes, the heart disease, the obesity. And that's why I hit the nutrition piece first, because that is so important. Mm-hmm. And we see just a rising rate now of kids with type 2 diabetes. Yeah. Kids 10, 12, 13 years old with type 2 diabetes. Mm-hmm. It's because of what we're putting in our bodies.
Yeah. And we don't know it. We don't know that what we're putting in our bodies is literally causing these defects, these diseases. Like we don't recognize, because it's not like you take it and then happens. It happens over time, but sugar tastes good. You know, sugar is more addictive than cocaine and heroin. They test with rats, test with humans, I can tell you right now, because of what it does. And so over time, we build this habit of basically eating the wrong things, which then puts us in that category. So you don't have to eat leaves off trees. You don't have to become, you know, a vegetarian. You don't have to do anything extreme.
Are you a vegetarian?
I'm not.
Okay.
I'm not. But you be mindful of what you're putting in your body. Like, if you're going to eat cupcakes and donuts today, then you need to shut that down for a few days. Ideally, for the rest of the week. Like, you have a cheat meal, not a cheat week or month. So it's all about, you know, how you systematically set it up. So a lot of times people won't lose weight or feel as if they don't have a shot, because they feel like they have to become this super diligent person that can't eat anything that they want to eat. And what you find out is that there's a lot of tasty, healthy stuff. A lot. You just never been exposed to it. So if you never went to Idaho, you don't know what's there. Come to Idaho, you know, take a look at the potatoes. They're good.
How do you pass that on to kids? That, hey, you might not have tried this before. This can be tasty.
Yeah. We make them taste it. We make them taste it, and they get to smell it. When you smell that stuff cooking and that curry, I mean, Roz made some curry cauliflower.
Oh, that's delicious. I've had that before.
I said I never would have ever deliberately eaten that. But when I smelled it, I was deliberately going to eat it. See, because what I knew about cauliflower, I just never really enjoyed anything about it. But prepared the right way, I go, oh, wow, these are a slight little shift.
We talked a little bit about the whole self-esteem piece. And you know that things are tough, especially for African-American males. Mm-hmm. And how do you instill, especially you may have some children who come from a broken home who don't have a whole lot of role models. How do you instill the right things in them? Especially you have a teenage son.
Yeah.
What are you putting in them?
That's a good question. You know, the best example is living the life that you want people to remember. So the example is through the behavior. You know, we talk about how we respect ourselves, how we respect other people, but then through the models that you see coming through the camp, the different presenters and mentors and coaches and the life that they've experienced and what they're showing you. So they get a chance to witness that. So they get to see the theory, but then they get to see the practicality by watching coach and watching people firsthand, how they interact and how you're supposed to interact, like understanding how you're supposed to interact and then seeing it actually done.
Do you have to work a lot on that? On how you're supposed to. Some kids don't do because they don't know.
Yeah, at most times that's what it is. And again, it's the repetition. It's the repetition. It's exposing the parents, because we also expose them to things to heighten their understanding, emotional intelligence, nutritional understanding, like all of it. We expose them through newsletters.
So, how do you do that?
So you got the newsletters, and then you have, more importantly, you have the show. So the show itself tells a pretty good story.
So you have a Camp Fit show. Mm-hmm. How does that work? So is it a daily show, weekly, monthly?
So for the eight weeks, we film. It makes it 8 episodes just for that season. Excuse me. So, you know, we didn't shoot last year, and we plan on shooting this year a little differently, but for the previous, we got 5 seasons that we filmed this, 8 weeks. Those are makes it 8 episodes for that one particular season. And throughout the season, you get to see, you know, different activities, you know, breakthroughs, some examples that you can then implement in your own home, make some adjustments.
And how do people access these shows?
So if you go to campfit.tv, you can access it. But if you type Camp Fit into Google, it comes up. Camp Fit into YouTube, it comes up.
And these are how long are the shows?
About 20 minutes. Okay, actually they are 28 minutes and 33 seconds because they had to be formatted for DirecTV or whatever. They have these.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Parameters.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So in watching your, that's another good thing that you can do in watching yourself do this. It puts it in a whole nother perspective.
Yeah, it does. It does.
Watching how you progress and mm-hmm. watching what exactly you were doing. A mm-hmm. lot of times you forget what happened, and to actually see the work in progress has to be amazing for the kids.
I wish I can give an accurate stat. A hypothesis is about 500%. Your potentiality moves up. The reason I gave that factor because I just learned that in flow state, you perform at 500% more better than in regular state. Flow state is when you are concentrating and focused on a particular thing. So when kids get to watch themselves, they then get to review it, comprehend it, and it accelerates their understanding of it, as opposed to just taking it in and trying to remember. When you take it in and then see it, then you can make those adjustments quicker. The quicker you make the adjustments, you got self-reflection and course correction. The quicker you can make the course correction, the quicker you'll get to your destination.
And you have both male and female participants mm-hmm. in the camp. Mm-hmm. How do you find them different? They're learning. How do they learn differently, the boys opposed to the girls? The
girls are more cerebral. Guys are the brutes. They're obviously more physical. But girls are more cerebral. I that's the biggest thing I notice. Like, they internalize things better. To say it, you know, boys are like they allow a lot more distractions. They're worried about a few more things. And like the girls are, they're just able to focus faster, which is really the answer. You know, boys eventually get there, then they move faster. Once they get it, they move faster than the girls. Once they get it, the girls get it quicker.
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah, it's interesting.
Is it half and half? Half boys, half girls?
It depends. Yeah, it could be 60-40.
Okay.
Yeah, it could be.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Is there anything new happening this year with Camp Fit? And I want to make sure everybody knows that Camp Fit will be partnering with us for the Sisters for Fitness
yes.
5K Run Walk.
Yes.
And you've partnered with us before, and it was a wonderful experience.
It was.
And I am just so excited that they will be a part of my whole mission, which is to bring health and fitness
yes.
to our community.
That's awesome. Yeah. I'm excited about it.
So in getting together this camp, are you going to be taking more participants? Are you going to be adding more features? Or you're just kind of taking it as it comes?
Yeah, kind of taking it as it comes. This is a year where we probably have more college kids coming back this year than ever before. And so I was still in the laboratory thinking about, you know, what we could do special. You know, obviously they're going to be there helping, mentoring. But I was thinking maybe I could have some of the college fraternities work with some of the other athletes that are in the football or basketball or whatever the sport may be. That would be great. And then we could show how that mentorship works. You know, we have some kids that are younger in the football and basketball on that journey, in the sports-related journey. And we have kids who've already gone through it and gotten to the top. So having that and being able to kind of experience what happens there, I think it'd be pretty phenomenal.
Yeah,
so
I think those will be some really great role models mm-hmm. for the kids, these kids coming back and
yeah.
see, look at me and look at how I've grown and what I've done, and
absolutely.
You can do this too.
That's it.
That is. Last question, though, I want to talk to you about weight loss successes as well. Have you seen some of the kids really take that with them mm-hmm. as far as weight, losing weight and kind of getting fit and staying fit?
Yeah, we have actually. Two in particular, so Jada, who's one of our first winners, for the first five seasons, we gave $1,000 to the child who not necessarily lost the most weight, but scored the highest in the five different categories. Mm-hmm. Jada was one of the first winners, and she actually became a vegan.
Wow.
Went home, transformed her house. They all eating. I think they're vegans too. I think the whole house is.
It's just interesting how you can impact the entire family.
Entire family.
Because the mom, of course, is the head. Mm-hmm. When it comes, most moms are the ones who do the shopping.
Yeah.
Sometimes my husband will go to the grocery store. But for the most part, it's me who is choosing and planning the meals. And I loved what you said earlier in the show about planning the meals ahead.
Mm-hmm.
That is absolutely the key, because we all want to grab and go.
Yeah.
And that's not the answer. It's planning ahead.
Mm-hmm.
So I just wanted to make sure we mentioned that you've had some weight loss successes as well. And nobody's telling anybody to be skinny, but be healthy.
Be healthy. Be healthy. We've had several weight loss. I know Jada and Zach, who came in, he's overweight. Another one of the ones who got in there, transformed himself, and I think he became the captain of the football team.
Wow.
And looks like he's going to Marines or something. I mean, it's totally different posture, just his delivery. Oh, absolutely amazing. And so something happens when you start to lose the weight. You start to become more confident. And whether you're overweight or not, you're still wonderful, right?
Yes.
You're still wonderful. But as you begin to shed off the weight and become the physical size that you know that you deserve or want to be, that happens in here. So that's what happened with him. And then the habits begin, and you've committed to this person, so that other person begins to dissipate.
Very good. We've been talking to Rob Howes, and he is the founder of Camp Fit. It is a fitness program for children, an 8-week summer program, and also the name of the TV program as well is Camp Fit.
Camp Fit.
Is Camp Fit. And you can see yourself, the transformations that happen over the years and over the 8 weeks. And you said that's spiritual, mental, and physical.
That's it.
Thank you so much,
Rob.
It's been a pleasure.
It's
a pleasure to have you participate in our 5K run walk this year.
Thank you. I'm
looking forward to it.
So am I.
You've been watching the Sisters for Fitness Wellness Show. I'm Stephanie Gaines Bryant. Have a great day.